Now the second, after obtaining the value of the shear force, we obtain the value or the equation for the bending moment across the span. Now for this section, we take the moments about an axis passing through the fixed end A. So we have at the end A, we have moment acting in anticlockwise direction. That's 1/3 of W naught L square. That's 1/3 of W naught L square. It's positive, being anticlockwise. And we have the moment that is M anticlockwise, whose equation we have to find out. So we are writing the value of M, and we have the moment because of this triangular distributed load. The moment because of this triangular distributed load will be equal to the magnitude of the load, that is 1/2 of W of X into X, that is 1/2 of 1/2 of W of X into X multiplied by the force arm, that is 2/3 of X, because this load will be acting at the centroid and the centroid will be at a distance 2/3 of X from the fixed end. And we have the moment because of this shear force, and the shear force tries to move the beam in the clockwise direction, tries to rotate it in clockwise direction. Therefore, the shear force moment because of shear force will be negative, and it will be V into X. So that's what we are writing, V into X being negative because it's clockwise. Now we have MA, 1/3 of W naught L square. M, we have to find out V of X. V we know is equal W naught by 2L into L square minus X square. It's here. And this equation, once we are doing little algebraic calculations, we obtain the value of this bending moment M. The value of this bending moment comes out equal to W naught by 6L and multiplied by minus 2L cube plus 3L square X minus X cube. So this is the equation 4 that gives us the variation of the bending moment across the span of the beam. Now we'll plot equation number 3 and equation number 4. We'll be plotting to obtain the shear force and the bending moment diagram. Now if you look at the plots, as far as the plot is concerned, first the plot for the shear force. As far as the plot for the shear force is concerned, the plot for the shear force will be obtained from this equation. At x is equal to 0, the value of V comes out equal to W naught by 2L into L square. That's W naught L by 2. That's here, W naught L by 2. It's positive. At x is equal to L, this is L square minus L square. V comes out equal to 0. So the value of shear force at the fixed end is 0. Now, since this is an equation, it is a quadratic equation, and if you take the second derivative, it will be negative, which shows that this equation varies from the fixed end x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L, but it will be concave downwards. So this is how the shear force will be varying across the span. This is the shear force diagram. Now look at the bending moment diagram. For x is equal to 0, this term is 0, this is term is 0. The bending moment for x is equal to 0 comes out equal to W naught by 6L minus 2L cube. That's W minus W naught by 3 into L square. That's here, minus W naught L square by 3 is the bending moment at the fixed end. Now put x is equal to L. This once you substitute x is equal to L in the bending moment equation, this entire term comes out to be equal to 0. So the bending moment at the fixed end is equal to 0. Now this equation is again it's a cubic equation. This is M varies as a cubic polynomial. It works varies as a function of x being the cubic the cubic polynomial. So if we take the second derivative of this M with respect to x, we'll again see it's negative, and it indicates that it's varying from minus W naught L square by 3 to 0, but being concave downwards. So this is how the graph of this, the bending moment varies along the span of the beam. So this we call as the shear force diagram. This is the bending moment diagram. So this and this are the shear force and the bending moment diagrams for a beam having triangular distribution of load over it, with the maximum intensity of the load being equal to L or W naught, and the span of the beam being equal to L.